How's it going, everybody? Peter here, and a warm welcome to my latest Let's Play of Train Sim World 4 on the Antelope Metrolink route. And today, folks, we're going to be working the LATC intermodal terminal to Seattle. And we've got a BNSF GE ES44C4 with 49 cars. And without further ado, let's get started. Folks, I am a big fan of the GE Gevo locomotives, and I do love the sound on this one. Thank you. Okay, so the horn has no effect on the alerter, so that will just go off regardless, so I have to cancel that even if I move the controls. As we're at least on the searchlight simulations, sound pack, all the trains today are classic, Givos that use that, sound set, scripts, when you move a control, blow the horn, it does cancel the alerter automatically, sadly, not on this one. Thank you. out there that make these eggs and adults and stuff, I wonder how hard it would be to make a tip of Gevo bottom out of one of the ES44s, as I would assume. I'm not an expert, by the way, folks, but I would assume that most of the modeling work would be on the large cooling fan pod area towards the back of the archive. That's just my assumption here, as I'm assuming that the cab and most other parts of the 3D model would very much remain identical, if that's correct. I do welcome your feedback, as I would like to see some table of Gevos with the angled exhaust and the straight exhaust plug on the first version of the production models, and perhaps the prototype demonstrators too. And in fact, to be truthful, folks, I would certainly welcome even a payware GE Tier 4 Gevo locomotive pack with all the various lights and stuff between the railroad operators. And if a pack like that came out, I would certainly purchase it, because I really do love those modern day heavy freight locomotives. Not gonna lie. Anyway, folks, I do hope that most of you that are enjoying this Let's Play along the Antelope route, and at least I now have the alerter turned on, so that just makes it more realistic, as it keeps me involved when doing these Let's Plays and stuff, and I just like this, you know. have to enjoy these trains. And I do look forward to the day where I can do some of these timetable apps again in a tier 4 GEVO, as I really would like to see a tier 4 GEVO pack come out for this train sim world tour, either as a freeware mod where it uses this GEVO as a base pack or as a standalone freeware pack. And in particular, I would like the Canadian National Heritage livery pack on the tier 4 GEVOs, correct versions of the locomotives as well. So I do hope that Dovetail Games will consider doing that one, as it would make for a nice pack, as I do have the Union Pacific SD17 Ace Heritage Pack, and I do have the Norfolk Southern Heritage Pack as well. So I really do like those. Would welcome Canadian National and others in the process. So it just helps me build up a nice collection of modern American freight locomotives. What do you think? As well as Canadian, of course. But anyway, folks, we've got this on lockshaped, so we do have a heavy train, and we still have 10 miles to go. We reach Lang Siding, that will be where we will finish, but I have no idea how long this will take. And come to think of it, I failed to check the locomotive behind me to see if the DPU switch was turned on, as then I could remotely control that help locomotive from the front cab, but no bother. We'll see how it goes. Well, folks, if I do get the opportunity to stop this train, such as a red signal or something, I will check the switches on the secondary locomotive. As I was trying to say that, I will check the switches on the secondary locomotive if I do come across a red signal, as I think DPU is turned off the secondary locomotive, hence why basically come to think of it, it's just this locomotive alone. It's falling all the 9 freight cars behind me. So I'm using all 4,400 horsepower just on this locomotive alone, and I do have a helper locomotive behind me. So what I'm going to do, once we get out of this tunnel, I'm going to stop the train just momentarily and make sure that the folks, we are going downhill, and I do find the brakes on this train are very, very weak, thankfully. We're now in a high speed zone, so I can now release the brakes again, and we can just coast. In fact, I think that was a bad mistake, as we're now back in a 50 miles an hour zone, but no bother. Need to. I'll just have to put the brakes on nice and early. line and pull himself. Thank you. Okay, that concludes this Let's Play. I'll see you in the next one.